People with street smarts, what is your most street tip? People make pickpockets' livelihood so easy. Just check out how many phones are in people's back pockets, how many handbags dangle by the side, easily accessible. Always put valuables in an inside, preferably zip pocket. If you're in a notorious pickpocket area like Paris or Naples, you can even carry a fake wallet with Monopoly money in an outside pocket. Look like you'll fight back. Not so much that it looks like you're issuing a challenge, but just so that anyone looking to get the 20 bucks in your wallet will wonder whether it's worth the effort. Buy a daily moisturizer with sunscreen in it. This guy has been through some serious it. Security guards, doormen, food cart owners, and blue collars in general, know where the closest bathrooms are. If you are a woman and have a handbag with a zipper, make sure the opening end is towards the front, where you can keep an eye on it. This prevents someone walking behind you from opening your handbag and taking your wallet, anything valuable. If you are a tourist and want a local to take a pic of you with your phone, either have it be an employee or someone you can outrun. Wear one headphone so you can still hear what's around you. I like to wear both, but turn them down and tune into what's being said around me sometimes. People say some weird it when they think you can't hear them. If I'm in an unfamiliar city, I'll explore freely every neighborhood as long as there are women and kids around. Most moms don't hang outside with their kids if the street area is unsafe. This worked very well for most throughout Latin America, Europe and Asia. If you want to know if you can trust somebody you let in your home, leave a $5 bill in a place that looks like it was forgotten about and that they would see it. If they'll take you $4.05 now, they'll take you four more later. Did this to my friend a few months after meeting. She came around, I had dropped a fiver on the floor on the way in. I went to change cake back and she said, "You dropped a fiver on the way in. I've put it in your wallet and put it on the table for you." Lo and behold, wallet on table with all my cash in it. Nothing even looked like it had been moved. Needless to say, on nights out where I feel too drunk to realize if I may lose my wallet, it goes in her bag. If I wander off and make it home, she's not gonna touch it until she's giving it back to me. She's playing the long game. I like it. She's eventually gonna take everything you own. Yeah, it is called divorce. Alternatively, don't trust them by default and save $5. There are 146 street suffixes acknowledged by the US Postal Service. Alphabetically, the first is alley and the last is yard. These are also bad places to duck into if you're being followed, because there's only one exit. Literal street information. He went literal first, then figurative. Top-notch comment. Don't talk if you don't need to. It's so hard sometimes, but the right thing to say in so many situations is nothing. In business meetings, I often let other people talk. I learn a lot more about who they are and what they value. This can be useful to advance my own agenda. Never turn your back to someone who you don't trust or is aggressive. YouTube is full of videos of people getting sucker punched from behind. Any street knowledge I have is from watching World Star and Live Leak videos. The most dangerous time to drive is right when it starts raining, cause any oil on the street has mixed with the water, making it slippery, but hasn't had enough time to wash away yet. It's the first snowfall here this weekend. I'm hunkering down at home so I don't have to drive around people that forgot last winter driving. This is a niche tip, but if you ever suspect something to have an electric current, do not touch it with the palm side of your hand. It can cause your muscles to contract and not let go. Always use the backside of your hand, or even better, use a blade of grass or something not too conductive. Don't freak with people. Even the skinniest, nerdiest Steve Urkel-looking Mather Fryker might be crazy with a knife under his sleeve, might stab you soon as you turn around. But don't be scared of people either. Mutual respect. Prison rules. Don't start it yet, don't take any it. In Australia we say, he who stirs the it, gets to lick the spoon. Get stabbed. Stabber. Did I do that? Always tell my kids to walk with a purpose. People who walk with a purpose make it happen. Don't hug the walls. Walk a bit towards the center, especially near corners. Keep your ears open. Notice things. Footsteps. Shuffling. Metal clanging. Anything. Basically, be aware of your surroundings and anticipate critical situations. Yup, yup. Learn to hone your instincts and trust those bad feelings that seem random. If it comes down to it, hit hard and hit first. There aren't any referees on the corner. Coincidences are rarely that. Pay attention to people's hands. They will give you a split-second heads-up to ill intent. Watch your effing back. Also watch their left foot. Most people are right-handed. If they inch their left foot closer to you, they are setting up to take a swing. And most untrained right-handed fighters will instinctively try to hit you with a right cross or hook. Very rarely a left jab. Conversely, you can rock people's it with an unexpected left jab. If someone bumps into you, or brushes against you, check your pockets. Here's this reflex people have when bumped up against. They will immediately go and check wherever they keep their wallet, money. So many times pickpockets will send in recon people who will just kinda get a little too close and bump into people. Then the actual pickpockets can see where you check and go for that pocket. Saw a TV show where ex-street con artists told of the tricks people use, so that viewers could guard against them. In some train stations, bus stations, etc., there are advertising posters put by the police or local authorities warning people against pickpockets. Do you know where your wallet is? People see the poster and immediately move their hand to the pocket where their wallet is, to check it was there. And by doing so, they give the location away to the pickpockets, who are watching. The people on the show said that posters like this help the pickpockets more than it reduced crime. Carry an extra wallet with $50 in it and throw it if someone tries to rob you. Street smarts. I think you mean money clip? Street smarts. You want it? Go get it. Walk confidently and with your head up. If you walk around like a freaking victim, you will eventually become a victim. This 100 times. Don't let anyone think they can mug you or tease you and get away with it. Because then they will, and they will get away with it. Yup, being confident when walking to Subway saved me from getting mugged. I told the guy to frick off and grow up. If anyone ever makes a conscious decision to steal anything from you, never trust them. Ever. If they will steal a lighter from you, they will steal your weed, your money, your jewelry, your car, you name it. Stay away from stupid motherfuckers. They'll get you in legal trouble, hurt, or kill despite their best intentions or how friendly they are. If you sell drugs, don't get sloppy. Sloppy equals weakness and somebody will set that ass up. $1 bills stack up over time. If you broke, a bag of potatoes is like $2.50. Backing down from a fight may hurt your ego, but will keep you alive longer. That being said, sometimes you gotta fight. Pick your battles wisely. Not everyone who calls themselves your friend is your friend. Not everyone you call a friend is a friend. If you even think for 1 second you should bail, get the frick up out of whatever situation you are in immediately. If you accidentally disrespect someone, apologize immediately. Buy them a beer / offer a cigarette. I've seen this save lives more often than not. Loud people bring the noise. Quiet people bring the guns. That being said, never underestimate how bad somebody wants to prove themselves. And watch out for live wires. A live wire is somebody who gets hyped up and excited easy. Will shoot first. Never ask questions. If you ain't from the streets, hood, ghetto, don't act like you are. If an older, street knowledgeable person tells you don't do, don't go, fill in the blank, don't freaking do it. Smoke weed. Don't frick with any type of powder. If the blunt is already rolled, don't smoke it. Never ever ever find out what somebody has in the trunk. Finally, look, listen, and learn. Talk to yourself. You'll make even the craziest fricker nervous. Pacing around and angrily muttering to your phone will keep even the dodgiest of crackheads at bay. Even better if you're not actually holding a phone in your hand. The frick you mean, why are you talking into a banana motherfricker? I will cut you. Let's say a kidnapper throws you in the back of a trunk. Don't panic. Once you get your bearings, find the carpet that covers the tail light. Peel back the carpet. Make a fist. Punch the tail light out the back of the car, thus creating a hole in the back of the automobile. Then stick your little hand out and wave to oncoming motorists to let them know that something hinky is going on. Avoid secondary locations at ALL. Costs. Yep. Assume you're already dead and find a way to fight back. Mind your own business. At restaurants or other establishments, sit with your back to a wall, no blind spots, and a view of the entrance. Beware of unsolicited kindness or help from strangers. People who carry guns often walk and posture a certain way. Learn to identify this. Don't be a hero. Never accept something free from someone you don't know. This is a big one in prison. Never assume or believe a woman you don't know if she says she's on birth control. If you commit crimes with people you know and get caught, expect them to rat on you. At the scene of an accident or overdose, don't expect or ask people to help. Tell them to. This tends to break the bystander effect. If you witness a serious crime, disappear. Getting involved in any way is bad news. If it's really important to you that you do the right thing, call an anonymous tip line. If someone's staring you down, nod your head down while maintaining eye contact. A harmless person will nod back. Look away. Don't hop trains your first time alone. In getting to know train hoppers and hobos, don't hit on a hobo or tramp's woman. You will probably end up with a bashed skull behind a bush. This is common enough to say something. Run if you need to. Hurt pride is temporary. Avoid meth heads. Avoid meth heads. Things often go very quiet before it hits the fan. You can feel it coming. This is very common in prison. I don't condone murder, but if for whatever reason you murder someone and have an accomplice, you should probably murder the person too. And any witnesses, have an exit plan at all times. Don't steal from criminals. Don't steal, period. Don't rob drug dealers in your neighborhood. A weapons enhancement on a robbery can be the difference between a few years and decades. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please smash the like button and leave a comment which story you liked the most. Subscribe and hit the bell notification for updates on our latest videos. And don't forget to check the links in the description box for more awesome content.